सर सर सर
सर
लेफ्ट में
चलो एक एक मिनट
अरे बैकड्रॉप किधर
इधर
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 शंकर
Good evening, and thank you again for coming in such large numbers and showing tremendous support. Now, as you all know, that 2.0 is possibly, everyone goes on and on about its budget and how expensive, and it's the most expensive movie of Indian cinema. And all that, of course, is true. But one has to actually regard, respect, and bow down to this genius's vision, this great filmmaker, Shankar sir, who actually has time and again proven that cinema has no boundary, will not have any boundary, and goes beyond its boundaries. This is not just a celluloid experience, a cinematic experience. It is going to be a cinematic delight. All of us are eager to see it. It, of course, releases on the 29th of this month worldwide, and everyone is ready with their 2D vision, their 3D glasses, and their 4D excitement. So it really is... It's in abundant, the excitement, the energy that surrounds it. And all of us at Dharma Productions are honored and privileged to be associated with 2.0. This is, of course, the coming together of so many tremendous forces. Rajni sir, the most respected, acclaimed, and loved actor of Indian cinema, is so beautifully helming the cast of this film. And this is the first time we have two cinema giants in the same frame. We have Akshay Kumar, lead actor, mainstream mega movie star, and Rajni sir, both together creating cinematic havoc as you've seen in the trailer. And of course, the genius, the legendary Shankar sir, who have time and again actually associated with just amazing things on celluloid. Today, of course, is our this end of the world ka launch. And we wanted you to share with us the excitement that we all have in our hearts, in our heads, and in our beings. What we're going to show you today is what you possibly have seen, but wear your 3D glasses and enjoy the trailer. And in addition to that, we have a song unit, Tuhire, to share with you. So ladies and gentlemen, as I said, buckle up, get ready. The film releases on the 29th. We will be in conversation with these two illustrious personalities right after you see what you see. Until then, we hope you enjoy the show. Good evening again. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, those were glimpses, the trailer, and of course the song with Rajni sir and Amy Jackson from the film 2.0. The unit will be out shortly. And now, to be in conversation with, as I said, two cinema giants, may I please invite on stage the man behind the vision of 2.0, the heartbeat of 2.0, and a bona fide cinema legend, Shankar sir. Kumar. Come, sir. बाद में करें अभी करें Shankar sir, welcome to Mumbai. And I know it's been a sleepless few months or few years, perhaps, with your journey on 2.0. And now it's the race to the finishing line. How does it feel, sir, at this time?
Yeah, I'm waiting for the audience reaction, how they are going to receive and how they are going to enjoy. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Well, not only you, sir, the entire nation and world is waiting for the 29th of November. It's such a big release and there's so much talk about the budget. But I said, like, at the top of this evening, that it's not about the budget just, it's about the vision. And it's about what you're bringing in terms of narrative and technology. How excited about you about everything that you've achieved, even in the zone of technology with 2.0?
Yeah, actually, I'm not starting the thing from technology. First, the script.
Right.
So, whatever the technology script demands, I'm going for it.
Right.
So, we have tried some new technologies. All technologies are existing one, but that cannot be utilized for this film. We have to design newly. I mean, a lot of setups are there. Like every setups takes a lot of time and a lot of budget. Setup means, for example, like if you would have seen in the trailer,
yes,
the cell man.
Right.
The cell man is a setup.
Right.
And the huge bird is a setup.
Right.
So to design that, it will take a lot of time and a lot of budget. And to give emotions to that characters, and it's a very challenging thing. So that has taken a lot of time. I believe that that will excite the audience.
Well, the best filmmakers in the world always say that the emotional connect is so much more important than the computer graphics or the technology that the film has. And you have always integrated emotion so powerfully in your narrative. So of course, everyone's very excited. Now the narrative is so vastly interesting, and everyone says there's much more to the film than what we even have seen and witnessed. There is seems to be some strong messaging. Now, nobody knows anything about it, including myself. Everybody keeps asking me about, like, what there is a seems to be, there is something like a layer beyond, and you've kept that closely guarded to yourself, and I'm sure you still want to. But is that what you've taken a big effort to make sure that really the core communication of the film is not yet out?
Yeah, because the surprise will go.
Yes.
So I lot of audience are not the material what we have already released.
Right. They're
telling, why are you revealing everything?
Yeah.
So we want to see everything in the theater.
Right.
So even I put myself as an audience first.
Right.
So as an audience, I don't want to know anything.
Right.
I want to go to the theater and sit and I want to enjoy.
Yeah.
So the same experience I want the audience to enjoy. So that's why I'm trying to hold, but still, you know, like people are able to make what it is.
Yeah.
And so that's it.
Oh, well, see, even there he's being so guarded. Like, of course, people are catching bits and pieces and putting them together. And if you kind of apply yourself, you know that there is a core communication. But of course, we're all waiting and very excited. Now, sir, this is your first collaboration with Akshay Kumar, who's been a mega star of Indian cinema and Hindi cinema. And such an exciting part for him. This is his first, well, for the lack of a better way of saying it, his first antagonist part on this scale and on this level. Was it an exciting experience working with him? Because we just saw this video that was released recently that we all put out about the tireless process that Akshay had to go through in terms of his look and in terms of the get-up, the makeup. So tell us more about just collaborating with Akshay on 2.0.
Yeah, it's really great. Like, see, I'm amazed by his discipline and the performance and the commitment. So, like, I have told so many times, but he had spent nearly 2.5 hours to 4 hours every day. And to remove that makeup, it takes 1 to 1.5 hours. And over that, we have given him lens and wig,
right,
prosthetic makeup, yeah, that I told before,
yeah,
and teeth.
Yeah.
Okay. And a heavy dress.
Right.
And we are shooting in a very hot sun.
Right. Oh, God.
So with all these tortures, he has to emote.
Yeah.
So he did a great job. Like, see, as I told, it's not just antagonist. Like,
yeah,
there's a lot of shades.
Yes.
And that's a very interesting part.
Right.
So that's why I think that he agreed to do this role. Yeah. It's not just an antagonist.
No, that it's fairly evident that there's much more than what meets the 3D vision right now. But we're very excited, Akshay. Your collaboration with Shankar sir and Rajini sir, it really has been talked about ever since its inception. You know, everyone, just the coming together of so many cinema giants must have been an exhilarating experience for all of you. And what was your experience in particular working with everyone?
Well, I learned a lot from the day one when I not even started shooting. When I went to LA, the whole structure, how they had put it,
right,
was an amazing experience. I sat down in LA, my whole body was scanned, everything was taken, measured, and it was an experience. I didn't know something like this exists.
Right.
And on the contrary, I would just say that there was so much to learn from Shankar sir, the way he has taken the whole movie. And like, to be honest, I got paid for this movie. I should have paid them to teach me so much. So this was an experience I'll never forget in my life. Yes, that whole thing about wearing that whole makeup for three and a half hours. Like, I'll tell you honestly, the kind of material they had given me was this thick.
Right.
Like, I used to shoot for 5 hours, 6 hours, and all the sweat used to remain inside. It cannot come out.
Yeah.
I had to be on liquid diet throughout the day. I can't eat anything. It was an experience. And I still remember when I used to remove the whole thing out, there was the sweat.
All accumulated.
Yeah, it was, but it is worth everything. Everything what I did, I've enjoyed it. And what I am going to see it, I'm going to be actually watching it on 29th, the whole film. I'm waiting to see it, what has happened, what they have done with the movie. Because it's just been a great experience.
It's not one day.
Yeah.
All these things, what he explained and I explained. I mean, from the prosthetic makeup
to
all these tortures.
Yeah.
Throughout the shoot, I mean, the whole call sheet what he has given, no? All the day, he has gone through these kind of efforts. I hope it will pay back.
I'll tell you something, that movie apni jagah hai. The way they're making is being done, the kind of prosthetic, the whole, I have about 3-4 different kind of looks. You can actually make a movie on that itself.
Yeah.
It's a different experience. It's a different game. It's not just standing in front of a green background and just working. It's completely, you have to, I cannot tell you. I still get into it. Because I couldn't, to be honest, I couldn't shoot continuously 6 days or 7 days a week. Yeah. I had to take a break. Right. They were kind enough to give me 1 day break, just take a break. Because even the lens was, I think it was the largest lens an eye can take it. I remember I got conjunctivitis also one of the days, and it was...
Oh God.
But that was...
Well, a very legendary filmmaker himself, James Cameron, once said that pain is temporary, film is forever. So I think that is something that most creative artists and filmmakers live by, that mantra, that, you know, pain is temporary, film is forever, because eventually the final result is what counts. And the final result from what we've seen looks spectacular. And as I said, the main communication of this is to say that you are still kind of not meeting with the entire material in the trailer. There's so much more in terms of narrative and in terms of messaging that the film has beyond its entertainment, its visual spectacleness, and of course, Shankar sir, sheer an absolute genius in executing narrative with emotion and technology. Now, the one big factor in the film and carrying forward from his own legacy is Rajini sir's huge, huge impact worldwide as a movie star, as a celebrated icon. Working with him, Akshay, must have been really, really, because every time I've interacted with him, it's like you're meeting the most humble man you've ever known.
Humble is the right word.
Yeah.
You're absolutely saying the right word. Humble is the right word. I still remember the first time when we came on stage about a few months back, And the first thing he comes and tells them, he says, this is not my movie, this is Akshay's movie. I said, come on, sir, it's not fair, this is your movie. But he is so humbled, he will always say something like this.
Yeah, yeah. And of course, Shankar sir, you've collaborated with Rajni sir, you know, several times. And was this experience any different, or was it always as seamless as it's been?
No, every film is becoming more and more simple and humble.
Right.
And more and more hardworking. So, see, the nice thing about him is like, whatever he does, it attracts. It's very interesting, and there is a style, there is a mass, no, like, and there is a scope for performance and fun.
Yeah.
No, everything is there, and he's also coming as an antagonist.
Right.
And the scientist.
Right.
And Chitti, we are going to see him again.
Yes, Chitti is, I mean, that is so exciting. I still remember the time when we saw Chitti for the first time, and when he shot his gun and said, Happy Diwali, folks. And when you had a similar moment here, it was such a glorious throwback to that energy and that moment. Like, it brought back great cinema nostalgia. And of course, seeing Rajni sir in this avatar has always been so exciting. And the fact that you've created this character from his stardom is truly magnificent. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is Shankar sir and Akshay Kumar for you. And I think due credit also, of course, has to be given big credit to the producers like our productions and Subhash Karan sir for actually having put together this, you know, magnificent spectacle. Being a producer myself, I know what it takes to kind of actually put out a film with this kind of expenditure, technology, vision, and just hope for better cinema.